Hola chicos y chicas, this is one of your coaches, Natalie. Today's tutorial is for las alacenas from Jalisco. The footwork is for both followers and leaders, with the exception that followers will be using the skirts. The video will start off with a breakdown of each sequence, moving on to the sequence order, and then it's going to be a run through of the entire song. Now for this sequence, there's going to be four repetitions when you're dancing along with the music. Also, make sure that you're keeping your knees bent while you're dancing it to help with the transition between each step. This is also going to help you when you're increasing the speed of your footwork so that you can dance along with the tempo of the music. One more note is that while the leaders are dancing, they should have their hands behind their back for this sequence and throughout the rest of the song. This sequence consists of you going side to side 6 times, turning to the left, and then going side to side 6 times, but turning to the right. Make sure that you're spotting as you're spinning, so you don't get as dizzy as if you weren't to spot. This also leads to cleaner turns. Make sure that you're staying grounded for your turns, so one foot is going to stay on the floor while the other is doing the work to make you spin. Sequence 3 is going to have 4 repetitions. For this step, make sure you're keeping your knees bent and you're doing it a little more bouncy because you're having to do these turns. It's also important for you to engage your core as well as your leg muscles so that you can do these spins really well and so that you don't lose your balance. Sequence 4 is going to have 4 repetitions. You're going to start off with the 2 heel jumps, going into 3 remates, and then 2 zapateados. The last step is the ankle breakers as you're sliding back. If you're going to be practicing with sneakers and you don't feel comfortable doing the ankle breakers, that's okay, you don't have to do it. If you are going to do it, make sure you listen to your body and you don't push your ankles too far because we don't want you to get injured. The 5th sequence is going to be 4 alternating turns. One foot is going to stay on the ground while the other is rotating your body. Your heel is going to scrape on the ground before the ball of your foot rotates your body. You're also going to do remates in between your turns. Make sure that you're spotting so that you have clean turns. Also pay attention to how your torso is leaning at the end of the turn. It should be leaning in the opposite direction of which your foot landed. There are going to be 4 repetitions of this sequence, and there's call and response of this step. What I mean by that is, after you scrape your right heel, your left heel is going to respond by tapping on the floor. That's going to create the call and response. The same goes for when you tap your left toes on the floor. After you tap your left toes, your right heel is going to respond by tapping on the floor. Make sure you're keeping your knees bent and doing bounce with just your knees. The last sequence is going to have 4 repetitions where you're going to jump and step to the left 2 times, do 5 carretillas, then you're going to jump, step to the right 2 times, and do 5 carretillas again. For the sequence order, I split it up into groups to help create a general layout of how the sequences appear throughout the song. So first it's going to be sequence 1 and 2, then 3, 4, and 5, next 6 and 2, and lastly sequence 1 and 7. This will make more sense as you practice it with the music, but I just wrote it like this so that you would know which sequence came after the next one and how they repeated. If you have any questions, join us on our scheduled Zoom calls where we will be happy to answer all of your questions.